Hey everyone, this is Viren and welcome back to my YouTube channel for another marketing tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create display ads from Google AdWords. A quick word before we get into the tutorial, if you have any video requests, you can always leave them as a comment on any of my videos and I will pick them up and make videos for you. In fact, this particular one was a request from one of the comments from a channel subscriber. Also, goes without failing, do subscribe to the channel to support me and keep learning something new every week. Let's jump right into the tutorial. In order to start making display campaigns, you need a Google AdWords account set up, and once you're into your account, you can just go under campaigns, create a new campaign. There are these different kind of goals that Google AdWords allow you to choose from: sales, leads, website traffic, and so on. If you hover over each of these cards, you'll see which of them supports display campaign. We'll just select website traffic for now. There's search, display, shopping, and video. Let me select display. Now under display, you can choose from standard display, smart display campaign, or Gmail. Standard is basically where you get to set up everything and choose all the targeting, the settings, and all of that. Smart display is an automated way of creating display campaigns where you just give in all the text and the images and Google will take care of the rest. And finally, there's Gmail campaigns with which you can reach your users right in their inbox. For this tutorial, I'm going to pick standard display campaign. You can continue after you add your business's website. Click on continue. Let's give the campaign a name. Select the location. India is good for me. There are more location options to choose from where you can specify if you want people, if you want to target people who are interested in these locations or people who actually are in these targeted locations. You can also exclude these locations if you want to. So I'm just going to select India and that'll be fine. The language English is fine. For bidding, what is selected by default is manual CPC, but you have other automated bid strategies as well, where you can select either a target cost per acquisition, you can try and maximize your clicks, or you can just maximize cost per mille, that is cost per 1,000 views. I'm going to leave this as manual CPC, where I will pay for clicks. Budget, I can allot a daily budget of say about 500 rupees. As always, there are two delivery methods, standard or accelerated. I'm going to leave this at standard. Accelerated basically means that Google will try and finish off all your budget as soon as possible. Standard means they will try and spread your budget throughout the day. And as I keep selecting these options, you will see the weekly estimates here changing. And these are the estimates for the number of clicks and the impressions I'm going to get in the week, along with the cost of these clicks. You can also get into some additional settings where you can choose to rotate between the different ads that we will create under this ad group, so that you can make sure your users get to see all the different kinds of ads you've created. You can schedule ads to run only certain times of the day. Start and end dates for the ad. It starts on 2nd October, which is today, and I have no end date. So it will continue running every day with the budget that I've added. Devices, you can cap the number of times someone sees your ad, add some URL options, create dynamic ads as well, and there are some content exclusions. So I'm going to leave all of these just the way it is. Create an ad group. You can give your ad group a name. And here we start selecting an audience. You can choose between these three options. What are the interests and habits of the audience? Have they interacted with your business before? This is basically for remarketing or similar audience lists. And what are they actively researching or planning? This basically means that if your user is searching for certain keywords on Google, you can pick those users and then show them some display ads. So let's just select this. Custom intent audiences, auto-created. Basically, these are audiences that the user already has created based on the content of my previous YouTube ads. So I can just select them and Google will know who to target. A better way would be to create your own custom intent audiences. Basically, what this means is that you will create a list of keywords, and whenever someone searches those kind of keywords on Google, YouTube, they get added to this intent audience and they will see your display ad. So let me quickly add some keywords here. We can also add some suggestions from here. Once you're done, you can just hit create. And finally, the last option is in-market audiences. And here you can basically just select broad categories. For example, if I select advertising and marketing services, Google will show these display ads to those people who are currently in the market looking for advertising and marketing services, which is pretty cool. So you can check these out as well. Once you're done, just click on done and the audience is added. We can also narrow down the demography. So I don't mind showing my ads to any gender. I'm just going to filter the age. Parental status and household income, again, does not make much of a difference to me. You can also select some content targeting options. What this section basically means is filtering the kind of websites where your display ad will show. So I don't want my marketing ad to be shown on, say, for example, a travel website. So I can filter all those things here. So keywords will basically, what this will do is you will add a bunch of keywords and Google will make sure that whenever your display ad is shown, that web particular website has a close relation with these keywords. The topics, again, you can add broad topics. Let's search for marketing as a topic. Brand management marketing. Search engine optimization and marketing. And done. So now my ads will only be shown on websites related to these topics. And the last option is placements, where you can basically select the websites, the YouTube channels, the apps where you want your ad to show your display ad. Automated targeting basically means that Google will automatically expand your targeting to find new audiences for you, and you want it to aggressively find new audience for you, or conservative, or none at all. You want them to strictly stick to the audience you have selected. I generally like to just stay with conservative automation. Use a CPC. Typically, they've suggested 12.58 for my ad. I'm going to start with something much, much lower, something like 2 rupees or something. And for this, I can see that my weekly clicks is going to be about 1.6k. minimum to 3.8k, which is great. And finally, let's create the display ad. You can upload existing ads if you downloaded them, just create a new responsive ad. You can add images or use Google's free library. When you click on add, there are multiple options. Automatically get your website scanned and pick images from there. Upload, use the recently used images, the previous assets that I have. So I think I have some previously used images. Let's use this one. So there are two kind of images you can upload. One is the image for the ad and another is the logo. So I can use this as image. Continue. I don't have my logo uploaded. For now, let me just pick this. This is the YouTube's logo. Technically should not be using this. Now I'll quickly fill up this content, a short headline, long headline, description and business name, the final URL where the user will be taken to when they click on the ad. You can also check out how this ad will look like on the display network, on YouTube and on Gmail for both mobile and desktop. What you just need to keep in mind while filling these options is that it's not necessary that the long headline is shown everywhere. Google could just use a short headline or just the long headline or just the description based on wherever your ad is being displayed and the real estate available there. So I'll just fill these up. There are other URL options. You can add tracking template and things like that if you want UTM parameters. Click on add to ad group. They want me to add a square image as well. This is because in a lot of places they might need a square image to create my ad. Click back on ad. There you go, the ad has been created. Now just click on create campaign. And that's it, the campaign is live. You can continue, look at the ad group, and when the ad starts running, you will see all of these stats associated with your ad, the clicks, impressions, click-through rate, CPC, and stuff like that. I already have this display campaign running. And like you can see, there are clicks, impressions, click-through rate is about 3%. I'm paying 0.9 for CPC and all of that. That's about it for this tutorial. I hope I was able to teach you something new. Do subscribe to my channel for more such marketing tutorials.